Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Movie Fanatics. I'm Brayden, and happy Halloween to everyone. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. And as always, of course, please stay safe. And with all that out of the way, let's jump right into my favorite horror movie of all time, the John Carpenter 1978 classic, Halloween. And before we get started, there is going to be tons of spoilers in this review, so if you've never seen this movie, please go watch it. It is amazing. Halloween was kind of an anomaly that happened. It was this thing that just blew up in people's minds and was like, oh my gosh, a really fantastic horror movie, because that's what Halloween is. It's a very fantastic movie, but it's simplistic. That's what it's all about. It's just a guy in a mask killing people on Halloween night. It's not this big, huge, epic thing. Those stories have their place in horror movies, but Halloween isn't like that. It's a very simple movie, and that's due to the directing, editing, and lighting and shot composition of this movie. Because this movie is gold. This movie is so well done, and I want to get into some of my favorite scenes of the movie. The first off is a scene that people don't really talk about a whole lot. It's a very simple scene. It's when Dr. Loomis is waiting at the Myers house for Michael, and he looks over and he sees the car that's been parked there the whole time, if he would have just turned around. Anyway, he sees the car and he's walking over. It's that simple scene. He sees the car and he's like, oh shoot, it's been there all along, we missed it. That must have been a heart attack for Dr. Loomis. Another one of my favorite scenes, of course, when Dr. Loomis shoots Michael off of the balcony. And what's weird is that in Halloween 1, it's 6 shots and gets shot off the back balcony, but since Halloween 2 picks up directly where the first one left off, it replays that scene, but he's shot 7 times and falls off the front balcony, even though Dr. Loomis says 6 times, you can clearly count 7 shots. I don't know, I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm not covering Halloween 2, I'll probably cover Halloween 2 next Halloween, but yeah, That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about the original Halloween. As I was saying, this movie's so well done, and a big props to that is to the actors, but mainly Donald Pleasence as Dr. Loomis. He completely sells this movie. He catapults the plot along. He catapults the movie along. Catapults everyone along. Also, I want to give a big props to Jamie Lee Curtis, which I think this was one of her first roles, or maybe this was her first role. She's really good in the movie, especially in the third act. She really embodies that very vulnerable final girl, and she probably is one of the greatest final girls in all of horror. Really awesome characters, and she does actually injure Michael. Like, she stabs a knitting needle into his neck, a coat hanger into his eye, and a knife to the gut. That's pretty good. I bet the final girl in any of the Jason movies will never do any of that. They just run. Actually, I'm saying that, I'm getting ahead of myself. We're not talking about Friday the 13th. We're talking about the OG Halloween, this movie that is a true classic in horror movies, a true classic in film. And I do have to talk about a couple of the film's flaws that are very, very minor. One of them is the scene where the sheriff's daughter is strangled in the car. They reuse the exact same little clip of sound a couple of times, which is not really anything major. And the other thing is some of the acting from the teenagers. Even Jamie Lee Curtis gets a little whiny in some of those screaming scenes, but that doesn't really bug me. It's just it's the one girl, I can't remember her name. I think it's Linda. All the totallys, she says, like, totally, totally, totally. I forget all my books, totally. It's just totally, 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 totally. There's a lot of totallys in this movie. Then again, it's over 40 years old. Maybe that's how just people talked back then. I don't know. I don't care. This movie's awesome. Go watch it now. Anyway, that's all that I have to really have to say about this movie. Everything that's been said about this movie has been said about this movie. This movie's been amazing. It's like an hour and 30 minutes. It feels like 20 minutes to me. Especially the third act is one of my favorite third acts in all of horror movies. The ending is arguably my favorite horror ending. There's a couple other horror endings that are really good, but in terms of slasher endings, definitely the best slasher ending and the best slasher movie, in my opinion. A lot of people probably have to agree. And yeah, this movie is amazing. Not only my favorite horror movie, this is also my favorite, in my top five favorite films of all time. This is my favorite slasher movie. I can watch this movie whenever. Sorry, I'm really tired. It's late at night. It could be July and I'll pop in Halloween. This will actually be the third time I'm gonna watch this movie on Halloween this year, because I watched it the past 2 years on Halloween, and this is my third time actually watching Halloween this year. I love this movie. You can see that. I adore this movie. This is one of my favorite movies ever made, in my top five favorite films. And Halloween, despite the little nitpicks I've noticed throughout the years, Halloween abso-freaking-lutely gets an A+. Thank you all so much for watching this video. Please make sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and you know the drill, write comments below about your thoughts on Halloween, and maybe what you're dressing up as for Halloween. And please stay safe this year, and as always, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. This is Bryn Braden from the Movie Fanatics, signing off, and now, I'm gonna go watch Halloween.